Good morning to all my dear students. Once again, I would like you to welcome to Rotary English Medium School. We make you all believe in yourself. So imbibe your ambitions to work consistently, as it is the step to help you act and succeed in your life. And so now, before beginning with the topic, let us start our day with a quote. Having presence of mind to react any situation on stage is what makes you the best performer. So whatever the situation may be, keep your spontaneity intact. Now you all are in a pandemic situation, and you all know that we are going with a very different crisis. You all are at home, you are studying online. So I want you all to take it in a positive way and keep studying, keep motivating yourself. And now let's move towards our topic. Let's see what's the topic about. That's Evans Tries O Level. See, looking at this chapter, you might have seen that this chapter has 30 pages. And looking at that, you all might be feeling that it's very lengthy, and many students feel it is somewhat tough. So this chapter is in the form of drama, and the characters speak among themselves. And so due to the conversation, students find the chapter lengthy and bit tough. But believe me students, it's easy. Only to know this topic better, take out the myth from your mind that the chapter is lengthy. We will try to do this chapter in an interesting way. So let's know about the author. Okay, Colin Dexter. The author who has written this story is Colin Dexter. His full name is Norman Colin Dexter. He was from England. He was born on 29th September 1930 and died on 21st March 2017. He was a famous English crime writer. His famous novel, Inspector Morse, you might have seen, this is a character also, and it's so popular, and it was famous TV series where Inspector Morse was casted from his novel in the time period between 1975 to 1999. Apart from this, he was expert in using medical terminology. Medical terminology means you might be aware of these words which is used in medical field. He had a lot of knowledge about medicines. He brought action, thrill, suspense in his stories. And now we will see the secret of this story with the topic. He was also honored with many awards. He also received McCavity Award for this stories which we are going to deal with, is Evans Tries O Level. So let's get started. Please see the page of your book. Once you will move towards, you will able to see dramatic personae. What do you mean by this? This is a Latin word we use mostly for the list of the characters. It means characters. And drama means that this chapter is in the form of drama. So they have given the characters, those who are there or who are going to play the role in the drama, that is called dramatic personae. So the first we'll see is the secretary of examination board. So you all have given your board exams somewhere in state, some in CBSE boards. You all know that CBSC. Now you are studying in CBSE. So it means that Central Board of Secondary Education. So who is responsible to conduct your board exams? CBSE. So similarly, the above board, which you are seeing in this slide, is going to conduct O-level exams. Next, the character is the governor of HM Prison, Oxford. So here, governor is responsible to conduct the exam. As you all know that in school, principal is responsible for the management of exams in the school. And here, you will see that governor has been given all this responsibility. And see here, you can see Oxford Castle. This, the picture you can see is Oxford Castle. This chapter is of England, and in reality, this castle was used as a prison from 1888 to 1996. Let's see the next character, James Evans. He is a prisoner and he is a protagonist. He is the main character of the story. He is actually a criminal, but he is facing his continental kleptomania. What do you mean by that? You will go through this word in the story. It means this is a disease. Many times you see that even though you have all the things, but if you see some things, you feel that this should be there with me. And this type of people try to skip or try to steal all these things. And so those people are called kleptomaniac. So he is having the problem of kleptomaniac. Then the next characters we will see are Mr. Jackson and Mr. Stephen. They both are prison officers. Officers under governor. They are there specially to ensure the conduct of exams smoothly. Then we can see the next character, the Reverend S. McCleary. So here, the Reverend, what do you mean by this? This is a title. Generally, it is used for religious leaders, ministers, or anyone who holds high authority. In Christians, they are referred as Reverend with respect. And McCleary, here, what role he has is he is a church minister in the story, and he's going to invigilate the prisoner, like how during school exams, your teachers or from other schools invigilate your exams to see the exams to be conducted very smoothly. So all these characters we are going to see next. We will see Mr. Carter and Mr. Bell. Here, Mr. Carter is detective superintendent and Mr. Bell is detective chief inspector. So before dealing with this topic, a beautiful question is raised in your textbook, which reads as, should criminals in prison be given the opportunity of learning and education? So dear students, just think. Now you are not there with me, but I would like you all to think about that. Should the prisoner should be given the education or not? Should they be given the chance? If you will ask me, yes. See, criminals are not made by the while they are born. Means they are not by the birth. There are many circumstances in their life they face, and then they become criminals. So we don't know the background of the criminals, and so at least the chance should be given by which they can educate themselves. And once they are educated, maybe the criminal can turn up into a proper person or a good gentleman. So now this story revolves around this criminal or prisoner Evans, who had tried to escape from jail successfully before 3 times. Now he is going to try to escape for one more time. The story starts with the statement that all the precautions have been taken to see that the O-level German examination is arranged in the prison for Evans, and it does not provide any means of escape. So here, let us understand the meaning of O-level exam. What do you mean by O-level exam? It is the general certificate of education, which is called as GCE. It is an ordinary level exam, which is also called as O-level. It was a subject-based academic qualification, which was introduced in 1951. If anyone qualifies O-level exam, then only that person is allowed to give A-level exam, which is advanced level. So now here the story starts as governor from Oxford prison calls the secretary. Of the examination board in the month of March. Now here they are having conversation, and while conversing, secretary said that although it's a slightly unusual request, means strange request. Here somewhere you can see that secretary tells that it is a strange request. It's real that Evans is going to appear for O-level exam, and your secretary is feeling that how he is going to appear. So here he does not find any reason for not helping that fellow, but somewhere he found it strange. Further, he confirmed with governor that there was only one fellow to appear for the exam. So when he confirmed that how many people are going to give the exam, so governor told that only one person, and then he says, right, you said. And that's it. So then governor says that it was, yes, only one. And then here you can see that the word chap is used. Chap called Evans. What do you mean by chap? Chap means a boy. It's an informal word. See, nowadays you all call your friends like, hello guys. It's an informal word. You cannot use it in an official way. Same way governor use a chap word for Evans. Further, governor says that Evans started taking his night level classes for O level since September. So now you can see September to March, so nearly 6 months he is taking the classes. Now here further he says that he has keen interest to get some sort of academic qualification, and so he wants to appear for the exam. Now here you can go through the word dead keen. It means that he's willing to do that. He wants that. And then further secretary asked if he was good. So governor replies that yes, he was the only one in the class, and so he had got individual attention. See, if the person get individual attention, individual tuition, so it means that the person can perform very well. And so here further governor also adds that it would have cost him a lot of packet. See, here you can go through the word, it would cost him a packet. It means that lot of money. It would be very expensive if he would be taking those classes outside. Now here, as he is in the jail, it is the government who is paying for his fees. But if he would be outside the jail, it would be he has to pay a lot of money for these classes. So that things they are conversing. Further, secretary says, let's give him a chance, shall we? So listening to secretary, governor is very happy and said that he was very kind and asked him the exact procedure to conduct the exam. Secretary replies not to worry about that and said that he would send all the needed documents to him and confirmed his name again. So he again confirms the name, and governor also replies by saying his full name, James Roderick Evans. Secretary further said governor to confirm just one thing, that was he violent sort of fellow? Because secretary wanted to know, as he was not a common man, he was a criminal, and so he wanted to know about his criminal record. So here governor said that he is not interested in his criminal, sorry, here you can see that secretary says that he's not interested in criminal record or anything, but as secretary has to conduct the exam, he was just concerned to know about that. So governor said, no, not, there was no record of violence. In fact, he was a quiet, pleasant sort of chap, means guy, a nice guy, bit of card, really. Bit of card means a good guy like that. Please mark those words. It means that he was an eccentric person. He was intelligent. He was witty. And he behaved somewhere differently. Then further he says, adding about him that he is a bit humorous. One of the stars at the Christmas music concert. So whenever the Christmas concert is taking place in the jail, he performs very well, he says. And people loved his performance. Always people love his performance. He also compared him to comedian Mike Yarwood. Here you can see the word in your textbook. So here he is saying that he was very good at imitating others, copying acts, but especially he was very good in imitating for Michael Yarwood. He is an English actor comedian. Further, he says that he's not sort of violent, he's just a congenital kleptomaniac. This word already I have explained you before while explaining about him, explaining about the character. So here once again, it's that he is having the habit of stealing the things. So already we have discussed this word while introducing him, but again I will explain, and so already it is done. So nothing else, that's all he says. And so here governor explains that even Ivans is not violent, only kleptomaniac. He decided to tell something, so governor was supposed to say something extra more, but then he stopped and decided to take all this care by himself. And there was something of Ivan's which governor did not share with secretary. So now further secretary added that presumably governor can arrange a room anywhere. In return governor replies that there was no such problem as Ivan's was in his own cell. So further he said if secretary had no problem, no objection, they can conduct the exam there. So you hear, he has to give his exam in jail and he has to take proper care. And as a student where you all give the exam, you all give the exam in your centers. But here, as he is a criminal, they have to take lot of care. So secretary thought it to be fine with the place. And then governor told him that they could call a person, parson, it means priest, a churchman from nearby church. Saint Mary Marks to invigilate. So secretary and governor chuckled. Here you have gone through the word chuckle. Chuckle means just laughed. And when governor shared his thoughts for having lot of parsons in Saint Mary Marks church, at last secretary had one more thought to keep Ivans incommunicado. What do you mean by incommunicado? It means to stop Ivans communicating with other person. So here they have to take care that he should not meet any person till his exam is completed. Politely, governor chuckled, laughed again, thanked him repeatedly and accept his request, because governor was so tensed and now secretary had accepted his request, and so now he thanked him repeatedly for that. And governor slowly cradled the phone, means that he kept phone's receiver slowly. As soon as he kept the phone, here governor calls out in his mind the name Ivans, Ivans, Ivans. Only one name is there in his mind, and that is Ivans. Here you can see governor has only one name in his mind because he talks to himself that Ivans the Brave. Here all the prisoner officers used to call Ivans the Brave. Why? Because he used to run away again and again. He used to break and he used to run away, and so he was called as Ivans the Brave. And your prisoner officers were also scared, and governor was also a little bit, he was just concerned that how the exams will be conducted, as he had escaped thrice from the prison. Now let's see the word here. But for the recent wave of unrest in the maximum security establishment up north, he wouldn't now be gracing the governor's premises in Oxford. See, this sentence is little bit complicated sentence in your textbook. So here, first you should understand that what this sentence wants to tell us. See here, the confusion starts due to these two words, that is but and for. It is a phrase which means except for, or if it were not for. So here author has used this type of words, and so here you can see that it would not have happened. Means what? Let's understand. See the word gracing, which usually means that gracefulness, which add gracefulness. When you use this word, see, commonly you use the word grace the occasion. It means that that person honors the occasion. So now let's understand this word in this sentence. Means the jail in which Ivans was locked up with maximum security establishment in north, but due to some recent wave of unrest, he was not supposed to kept there. And so now he was gracing, means he was kept at governor's premises in Oxford. And now governor was going to make absolutely certain that he wouldn't be disgracing them. So why this word is used? Because he thinks that he should not do such type of thing that it would disgrace his image, governor's image. And it's further, the sentence continues that as if now Evans was at governor's place, he should not disgrace them by going something wrong. He shouldn't try to break out from his security, because now it's responsibility, it was the responsibility of governor. It was not that Evans was a real burden, but just a persistent and nagging presence means his presence was uncomfortable. He added, thinking that Evans would be all right in Oxford, as the governor would see to it personally. And also, he thought maybe there was slight possibility that Evans was interested in O-level exam. Just a slight possibility and just a slight possibility. Now, at 8:30 p.m., that's Monday, 7th June, Evans' German teacher shook hands with Evans at the high-security recreational block, which was across the D-wing, opposite of D-wing. Here, you can see across means opposite of D-wing. He wished him good luck in German. What's that? Guten Glück, her exam. So here, you can see in your textbook that's written in German language, but Evans couldn't understand, as we all also do not understand this language, but we come to know that it means that he wished him best luck. So then Evans said him pardon. So once again, the teacher said, good luck for tomorrow. Oh, thanks, sir. So here, you can see in this way, Evans thanked his teacher. The teacher commented that Evans was not prepared and didn't have a slight chance to pass the exam. So here you can see the teacher is telling that he does not have a slightest chance also to pass the exam. So, here, a captain has chance of getting through. This word is used in your textbook. This is an idiom, and this signifies that you don't have any chance to pass. Means not a slightest possibility also, because here, with this sentence, you can understand that Evans is not prepared for the exam. But here you can see that the teacher stops, and then Evans said he would surprise everybody. So now what would be that surprise? That we will come to know when we will move ahead. So now what happens next is, next morning at 8:30 a.m. Evans was visited by two men. You can see here, he tucked his dirty string vest into his dirty trousers and stood up from his bunk. Bunk means bed, and which was attached to a wall. He greeted Mr. Jackson cheerfully and said that it was an honor for him and he wished him good morning. So Jackson was the senior officer of D-Wing, and both Jackson and Evans were warm enemies. You all know that police and criminals cannot be a friends. So here you can see that every time Jackson would visit, he would say something wrong which Evans would not like, and so here it is told that they were warm enemies. Now here, there was one more character, you can see, he's Stephen. So Stephen stood by Jackson, who was burly, surly looking man. What do you mean by that? Burly means large and strong man. And surly means bad tempered, who is very unfriendly. So this type of man was standing near the Jackson. So here, Jackson greeted him briefly and rudely asked him, coldly means briefly, and he asked him about how was the little Einstein. So here you can see little Einstein he is telling, because here he is taunting him with Einstein's name. Here we know that Einstein was very intelligent, and somewhere Jackson knows that this Evans is not ready to give the exam, and somewhere he is planning something wrong. And so for this, what Evans replied us, let's see. That he says that if he wasn't the mathematician, and further said he thought he was a Jew. So here you know that Einstein was a Jew Christian, so he is talking about him. So he's not more concerned about Einstein, he's talking about his religion. Here you can go through some words, that is wasn't a, think a. So these are the short form which are used for he. So here further we can see that it is told that Evans had not shaved and he had wore a filthy looking red white bobble hat. So this, see, I have added in the picture, this is called bobble hat. So filthy looking means it was very dull. And he then asked Jackson to excuse him as he was going to shave, and both of them entered his cell. So here he says that now he has lot of work because he had not shaved and he wanted to shave. So he tells that he has to do lot of work, and so he asks them to leave as he wanted to complete his work. So in this we can understand that now Evans is going preparing for his O-level exam. Somewhere we can see that he may try to escape the prison, and there is governor who is looking after the exams, and then you can see these two officers, those who are taking care of the exam. And so here we will end this story, and next part we will continue further. So thank you.